Good morning, folks. Welcome to the...
Hello.
Yes, we're just having a cup of coffee. We've been chatting because we've had some exciting news to talk about, which we'll share with you in a minute. This is the quarterfinal review. I can't believe we're nearly at the end.
I know. You think about it. One, two, three, including a review, 4 weeks.
4 weeks and we'll have a winner. I do know all the cups, mugs have been received.
Oh, good.
By our semi-finalists. Mm. But I think we need to tell the result now because it's major. It is tense. So you need to bring up the...
Yes. Have I won millions on the pools draw? The answer is, if you went for a score draw, yes. Because it's a dead heat.
It's the very first proper dead heat that we've had.
Mm-hmm.
I knew this was going to be close.
Yes.
So guess what's sitting tonight?
The pools panel is sitting tonight. Hooray.
So if there's anybody that usually comes up and is watching this, you need to come up. We're going to try and do this sometime between 9 and 9.30 to give people plenty of time to get up on screen. So there will be a pools panel tonight. And unfortunately, the people that are involved, they can't vote.
Yeah,
it's got to be independent. So, and Dave and I can't vote. So that's going to be exciting. So we can now bring up.
I can now. Well, are you going to bring up yours or are we going
to bring up mine first?
Bring up that. Yeah.
So there we go. This is the quarterfinals. And we've had that because of all the issues. We've had these votes are more in line.
Yeah.
So
I still reckon somebody somewhere is trying to game the system, but we've made it an awful lot more difficult.
Yes. So, at first was that giant one, wasn't it? It was the who against the who.
Yes. Yes.
Quadrophenia and who's next. And it was not as tight as I thought it would be. I thought this would be a little tighter, but
Stevie did an absolutely brilliant job of promoting both albums.
He did, which was, I think, was very, very...
It was very honourable. Yes, it was.
His knowledge of The Who was great, so he could do both albums for us, which was superb, and it was a nice presentation. So thank you, Stevie. I know we've said it before, but...
Yeah. So which way would you have voted? Which way would I have voted? Well, brutally honest, I would have gone for Who's Next because I think it's the better of the two.
Yeah, in my rankings, Who's Next was my favourite album. And to be quite honest, as much as I like Quadrophenia,
there's a certain track on Who's Next that I've got in what I call my shower playlist. Wake up in the morning, step into the shower.
Babbo O'Reilly's
on the playlist. It's around.
Yeah. You can't go wrong with that one. And, you know, it was a tough one. It was a tough one. But Who's Next came out first, and that was Mick.
Mm-hmm.
And so well done to Mick on that one.
So I'm just making a little note. Quadrophenia will be deleted from the wheel.
Yes, we're going to do that in a moment.
Tie
2. This was Richard McCook's Bridge Over Troubled Water and David Hunt's Never Mind the Doo-Doos.
Yes, never mind the asterisks.
Yes, because when I did his mug on Redbubble, I just put because if people don't know, all the mugs got their album on it. And Red Bull went into panic mode. They wouldn't let me print it with the word.
Who?
Redbubble.
Yeah, for a moment. Sorry, I thought you said Red Bull for a moment. I got what?
So I had to put some little dots in and it went off. Fine.
Yeah.
Now, This was
I know where my vote would have gone.
Yeah, you would have gone for Bridge Over Troubled Water.
Yes, yes, because it's been in my music collection, as it were, from day one. It's been an album that's been there from day one. It blew my mind whenever it came out, and it's to this day it still does. I know all the songs.
Now I remember. I remember Bridge Over Troubled Water. It's the first album I ever knew because Dad was playing it constantly. I would have been three or four, not mm-hmm. that old, and for me to have that impact on me. And remember these songs, especially Baby Driver. That song's always had something. And I remember, of course, Never Mind the Bollocks coming out. But the one that sticks in my mind forever will always be Bridge Over Troubled Water. Sorry, David, I love the Sex Pistols album, but I think it's because of it's the very first album I ever, ever remember. And I remember going to a wedding. One of my dad's friends got married and they played The Boxer.
Excellent.
Yeah. And I remember, it was one of the places that when we had the only time we had a terrorist thing during the 70s, the place that was in 74 and the place we had it in was blown up. And a little bit of a mess over certain things. And that's a political thing. But, yeah, that's why. Congratulations to David.
Yes.
And congratulations for Richard. But I would have gone with Bridge Over Troubled Water.
Yeah.
Quarter 5-1-3.
Close
one. Charles's The Colour of Spring.
As has been the joke all through, this is the dark horse.
Yes, it is.
This is the one that's made it over Beecher's Brook. He's made it over the chair. He's coming round the Tattenham Corner. He's heading towards the home straight.
Yes, and that was up against, was it Pulsar? It was Pulsar's Revolver, wasn't it? If I remember.
Let me just have a quick look. Yes, it was.
Oh, whoa, dear me. This vote was going one, dun, dun, all through it the was. Week.
It was going backwards and forwards, up and down, up and down. And eventually, Talk took a one vote lead. Oh, no, actually, it went to a two vote lead. And very late in the day, there was a vote for Revolver, but not enough.
So how would you have gone?
Well, I actually went back, excuse me, I actually went back and listened to both albums again, back to back. And I put them on The Colour of Spring and then Revolver. So I was listening to the home version, then the away. And I ended up going back and said, actually, Colour of Spring. I went with Talk.
Wow. And you're not what I call a Talk fan.
No.
What was that? What swung it, do you think?
In a way, the freshness. I'd heard all the Beatles stuff so many times. And then go and listen to Talk. And it was new. Okay. I've got to listen to this, you know, from the perspective of I'm listening to this for the first time. How would I approach this? You know, what would my feelings be? I've heard so much Beatles. You hear it on the radio all the time. Every day, somewhere, there is a Beatles song being played. And yes, Revolver's got a load of stuff. I hear it too often. Colour of Spring is fresh. It's new. I like that. Okay. I'll go with The Colour of Spring.
Now, mine's very similar. I love Revolver. Don't get me wrong. I love the album. Absolutely brilliant album. One of their best albums. Now, the thing with Talk Talk's Colour of Spring, it was that album that they went from this boy synth poppy band to a more mature sound with fusion music, a fusion of prog, classical and jazz, because there's a lot of classical elements in there. As I said last week, Mark Hollis was inspired. And when you listen to it, and it, I listen to it under the headphones a lot, because you hear things differently than when you've got it on the thing. And it's a well-executed album.
As you say, I mean, I've been listening to it, on She Who Must Not Be Named. Hello, dear. Also on the laptop, and then through the headphones.
It's on a thing. So, yeah, my phone's going off, and is it actually in the other room? So we'll carry on. So
there it goes. There it goes.
It'll go off in a minute. Yes, there we go.
Right.
It's Colour of Spring. And well done to Charles. So a mug went hurtling across the water. Just up the road from Dave.
Yeah.
We won't say where, but it's now on this one. I know it's there because Charles actually sent me an email to say thank you.
Excellent, excellent.
So we come to quarterfinal three, and we're not going to tell four even.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to, we're not going to tell you how we're going to vote. We'll tell you later. But this was, it looked like it was going to be Peppers.
It did, right until the last minute. literally the last minute.
Someone put in a vote at the death hour.
Yeah. Which,
so we've got a 12-all draw.
So we have a sitting of the pools panel tonight.
Yes. So that's the quarterfinal. It was an exciting one. We've got that done. So we've got to do a little bit of housework. Saturday's draw. And the draw master for the semi-finals is no other than, from all the way from Leeds, it's our wonderful panelist who's up practically every week. He's part of the furniture of the live stream now. The one and only Mr. Mike Vinyl Spiral, a very good friend of the channel and a very good friend of mine now. You know, we're doing something later in the year which Dave knows about. Is going to be very exciting. So we're going to do a little bit of housework. Like we did for Richard, we're going to allocate numbers to names of albums ready for Mike's draw. So I've got my bit of paper that's got 1, 2, 3, 4 on it. And I've got my faithful, you remember these pens? I just thought
Good Lord, yes.
You can
still going?
Yes, I brought these. I use these all the time because it's just easier to think. So I want to make sure we haven't got the same colour. Right, there we go. So, Dave brings up the magic wheel.
There's the wheel. So
let's take out
Quadrophenia Lost.
Lost.
So Quadrophenia goes close to the edge. Well, Revolver has lost. Bridge Over Troubled Waters has lost. Now, that leaves us with five slices. So you'll see here I've already done a little bit of housekeeping. So you can see here The Beatles, Sgt. Pepper, or, yes, Close to the Edge. Because we're doing this like the old FA Cup. So for clarity, we're taking out Close to the Edge.
Four wedges.
Yeah.
Shall we get this little bit underway?
So spin the wheel for the first home.
For the ball one. Who gets ball one in the semi-finals? It's who's next. There we go. I have wrote that down.
Okay.
Okay. Ball two will go to Sergeant Pepper.
Or
close to the edge.
Yeah.
Okay. Who gets ball three and ball four?
Well, ball three is going to be Talk
the Dark Horse.
And just to prove, just for giggles, we know who it is. But, ba-boom! Ball number four will be the Sex Pistols.
So there we go. That's all ready for Saturday. Not quite sure what time the draw is, because we've still got to speak to your Michael. So, I'm sure we'll sort it out tonight, and you'll hear tonight exactly what time that draw will be done.
So,
I've now got to go shopping because I know what that phone call was.
It'll have been Lee. Yes, you're that would
have been driver. Lee. So, so I'm not going to edit that likewise. Out.
Yes, likewise, I've got to go and do some shopping as well.
And we'll see you promptly at 8 p.m. tonight, which is 12 noon Pacific Daylight Time, 3 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, and Japan.
Oh, crikey.
What? So it's about 4 o'clock in the morning, isn't it? Stupid.
Let's see. It's 11 plus 8. Yes, 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, I thought it was something like that.
Yeah, so if we don't do the pulse panel until after 9, that's after 5 o'clock in the morning. So hopefully Michael will be up and with us.
Up and with us. So hey, leave so to Tom, we'll see you later. That's the way to put it. So bye.
Bye for now.